Hello and welcome to Down the Scope. Today we'll be looking at the histology of the cerebellum. The cerebellum is located at the back of the brain and looks a bit like a cauliflower when you split it down the middle. The function of the cerebellum is to coordinate movement, maintain posture and balance. Before we start, I thought I'd mention that this video assumed some prior knowledge of neurohistology. If you want an introduction to neurohistology, including anatomy of the meninges and identification of different types of cell in the brain, I recommend checking out the video I uploaded previously, Brain Histology, You're on Your Way to Understanding It. Looking at the cerebellum at low power, we can see some macroscopic anatomic features. At the root of the cerebellum, there's a central core of white matter. Sometimes this white matter is referred to as the cerebellar medulla, following the standard anatomic naming of medulla in the middle and cortex on the outside. This sends out branches, which then branch once more and head off into the cerebellar cortex. Each individual white matter core with its cortical covering is called a folium, or folia in the plural. The structure of the folium is based around three layers of cortex that cover the white matter core. At low power, you can see two of these layers, the molecular layer, which is not very cellular and therefore pink, and the granular layer, which is very cellular and much more blue-purple. Before we get into the weeds on the cells in the cerebellum, it's worth looking at a schematic. Basically, cerebellar histology is all about the neurons and interneurons, interneurons being the cells that enable communication between neurons. So the thing you'll probably need to learn is which neurons are where and where they're sending their axons and dendrites to. During the next section, we'll be discussing four layers and five different types of neuron. The four layers are the molecular layer, the Purkinje cell layer, the granular layer, and the white matter medulla. The five types of neuron are stellate cells, basket cells, Golgi cells, Purkinje cells, and granule cells. So just keep those in your head or pause the video and write them down before the explanation. I'll try not to get too bogged down in the details of neuroanatomy because it's not important from a histologic perspective, but it does give some context to what you can see on the slide. With that in mind, let's move to higher power and have a closer look at the structure of the cerebellar cortex. The way I'd like to think about this is to imagine the pathway a nerve impulse would take through the cerebellum. The cerebellum receives sensory information from the brainstem and motor commands from the motor cortex in the cerebrum. These impulses are carried through the white matter by axons known as mossy fibers, which originate from multiple brainstem nuclei. There is also a second type of fiber called climbing fibers, but we'll come onto those in just a moment. The mossy fibers synapse with granule cells in the granular layer. Most cell nuclei that you can see in the granular layer belong to granule cells. These are the smallest and most numerous neurons in the brain. So all of these dark little nuclei with little cytoplasm belong to granule cells. These granule cells will then send axons up through the Purkinje cell layer, which is just this layer of single cells here, to the molecular layer where they synapse with dendrites from the Purkinje cells. These axons are known as parallel fibers because they often head up into the molecular layer and then branch out parallel to the layered structure of the cortex. Purkinje cells, which we can see in the Purkinje cell layer, are amongst the largest neurons in the brain, and here's a good example of one. It has a huge cell body with a large nucleus and a single nucleolus. The distinctive feature of the Purkinje cell is their large branching dendrites that they send out into the molecular layer. You can see just a little bit of the extent of it on H&E sections, and in fact, there's a good section on this slide where the Purkinje cells are very condensed, and you can see their dendrites coming out and forming these huge branching networks all the way up into the top of the molecular layer. Purkinje cells are effectively the output cells of the cerebellum. They process the information from the granule cells to effect a single output, which returns via the Purkinje cell axon through the granular layer, through the white matter, and down to the cerebellar nuclei. The huge dendritic tree of a Purkinje cell means that they receive input from a large number of other cells, the sum of which results in either stimulation or inhibition of an action potential. Purkinje cells themselves are inhibitory on their target neurons. Now, not all of the input to the Purkinje cells comes from the granule cells. Do you remember the climbing fibers that we mentioned earlier? Well, these come directly from the white matter, pass through the granular layer, and synapse directly with the Purkinje cells in the molecular layer, bypassing the granule cells entirely. So if the granule cells are the inputs and the Purkinje cells are the outputs, what are the other three types of neuron and where are they? Two of the three neuron types are in the molecular layer. These are the stellate cells and the basket cells. Stellate cells will receive input from the parallel fibers of the granule cells. Their axons synapse on Purkinje cells and have an inhibitory effect, so modulating the activity of the Purkinje cells. Basket cells will send out dendrites that wrap around the Purkinje cell bodies, making them look like little baskets that contain the Purkinje cell, hence the name. Basket cells receive input from the parallel fibers and climbing fibers, as well as stellate cells and other basket cells. Ultimately, they also inhibit the activity of Purkinje cells. In terms of identifying these cell types, you won't be able to tell the difference between a basket and a stellate cell using standard stains. And remember that some of the cell nuclei in the molecular layer will belong to glial cells like astrocytes. So you'll be looking for the typical features of a neuron, but much more scaled down. So maybe these cells will have a bit more cytoplasm. You might be able to see projections coming off them, and they'll generally have larger, more dispersed nuclei with nucleoli. So for example, this cell here has a bit more cytoplasm to it. Maybe you could convince yourself that it has a little projection coming up into a little triangle to send off an axon or a dendrite. So this would be a candidate for either a stellate cell or basket cell. Now, because it's more deep within the molecular layer, you could argue that it's probably a basket cell because it's going to be sending out a dendrite network to wrap around the Purkinje cells. And this cell here as well has a bit more cytoplasm. This one here has a nucleolus, so maybe these are basket cells as well. We come over up into the more superficial parts of the molecular layer. There's a good cell here with a bit more cytoplasm than the others and a nucleolus. So perhaps this one here is a stellate cell. The final type of neuron that we're going to talk about is the Golgi cell. These are located in the granular layer. They're medium-sized neurons, so they're quite easy to spot amongst the much smaller granule cells. Their function is to inhibit and modulate the activity of the granule cells. So they'll receive input from both mossy fibers and parallel fibers. So let's see if we can find some examples. There's an okay example here. You can see that this is quite a large cell with lots of cytoplasm. Its nucleus isn't particularly well preserved in the granular layer, so this is probably a Golgi cell. This one here is a bit similar. So as this one here, the nuclei aren't very well preserved, but they're much larger than the granule cells. And just over here, we've got ones that are a bit better preserved. We can just about make out the nucleus with a nucleolus in this cell and the typical enlarged cytoplasm of a neuron. So this is a Golgi cell. Now, all the cell connections are quite confusing, and there are loads of great videos on that more schematic and abstract aspect of cerebellar anatomy. So let's just review the histology. The cerebellar cortex is made up of three layers. The outer molecular layer, you'll find the cell bodies of stellate and basket cells. The neuropil here is a huge mishmash of dendrites and axons from all the different neurons in the cerebellum. The next layer is the Purkinje cell layer, which is a single layer of large Purkinje cells. Next is the granular layer, which is mainly made up of granule cells, but there are also some Golgi cells, which are larger. Underneath the cortex, there's a core of white matter, which is the cerebellar medulla, and will contain axons that are traveling to the cerebellum, such as the mossy fibers and the climbing fibers, as well as the Purkinje cell axons, which will be taking nerve impulses away from the cerebellum. Hopefully that was a helpful explanation. If you have any questions or would like to request a histology subject that you find particularly tricky for a future video, then leave a comment below. Otherwise, thank you for watching, and until next time, goodbye.